are going to see chapter 2 in accountancy, not for profit organization, not for profit organization, otherwise non-profit organization. The name itself implies these organizations are established not to earn profit. Then why it is established? It is established for providing services. It is established for providing services. Then it is established for promoting and or developing education, arts, science, culture, sports, etc. Examples for non-profit organizations are charitable institutions, hospitals, literary associations, sports club, recreation club, etc. Okay, they are said to be a non-profit organization. How they are raising their funds? They are raising their funds through donations. Donations means anbalipu. Subscriptions from members. Subscriptions means maada sanda illa varada sanda. To become the member, they have to pay subscription. So it is collected. Grants from government. Grants na maniyam. Grants from governments, etc. Features or characteristics of non-profit organization. The main aim is not to earn profit. Then why it is established? It is established to provide service to a specific group. And number three, they do not undertake any trading activities. Why they are not undertaking any trading activities? Means trading, the main aim is to earn profit. So they will not undertake any trading activities. And they raise funds through donations, subscriptions, etc. Accounts to be prepared by these organizations. There are three accounts to be prepared. Number one is receipts and payments account. Number two is income and expenditure account. And number three is balance sheet. First we will see receipts and payments account. What is receipts and payments account? It is nothing but summary of cash and bank transactions. When it is prepared? It is prepared at the end of the accounting period for ascertaining the closing cash and bank balance. It is a real account. Why it is a real account? Because it records only cash and bank balance, cash and bank transactions, cash and bank, both are assets. So it is a real account. Records all the cash receipts on the debit side of the receipts and payments account and all the cash payments on the credit side. And it records all the items, whether it may be capital or revenue. What do you mean by capital? Capital means those items which are not recurring in nature, which does not occur often. Revenue means occurs often, which are routine in nature, recurring in nature. The items recorded in the receipts and payments account may relate either to previous year or current year and subsequent year also. Non-cash items are depreciation, outstanding expenses, prepaid expenses, like not recorded. Depreciation, outstanding expenses, they are said to be non-cash items. They will not be recorded in receipts and payments account. I'll summarize it once again. Receipts and payments account is a real account. It is a summary of cash and bank transaction prepared at the end of the accounting period for ascertaining the closing cash and bank balance. It records all the cash receipts on the debit side and all the cash payments on the credit side. Records all the items, both capital as well as revenue. The items may relate to previous year, current year and subsequent year. Non-cash items are not recorded. Depreciation and outstanding expenses. Steps in preparing receipts and payments account. The first step is we have to record the opening balance of cash as to balance brought down. On the debit side, both opening balance of cash and bank will be recorded on the debit side. Suppose if the bank shows unfavorable balance, credit balance, that means it represents bank OD and it will be recorded as by balance brought down. All the cash receipts are recorded on the debit side of receipts and payments account and all the cash payments are recorded on the credit side. The items may be capital or revenue and it may belong to current year, previous year and subsequent year. If the debit side is greater than the credit side, then the balancing figure will be recorded in the credit side as by balance carried down. And it represents closing balance of cash and bank. Suppose if the debit side is lesser than the credit side, or otherwise if the credit side is greater than the debit side, the balancing figure appears on the debit side as to balance carried down. It represents bank overdraft. Cash will always show debit balance only, but bank only, sometimes it may show credit balance. So it will be recorded as to balance carried down, bank overdraft. Number 2, income and expenditure account. What is it? It is a summary of income and expenditure prepared at the end of the accounting period. Again, for what purpose? For ascertaining the surplus or deficit. What do you mean by surplus? When our incomes are more than our expenses, it represents surplus. And when our incomes are less than the expenses, then it represents deficit. It is a nominal account. And it records only revenue receipts and revenue expenditures, and that too relating only to the current accounting period. And it is accrual basis of accounting. That means what? It not only record cash items, but also outstanding salaries, depreciation, non-cash items are also recorded. And it is similar to profit and loss account. Records expenses on the debit side and incomes on the credit side. Non-cash items are also recorded, prepared from the given receipts and payments account. So that is, income and expenditure account is prepared only from receipts and payments account. Steps in the preparation of income and expenditure account. Step number 1. Opening and closing balances of cash and bank accounts in receipts and payments account must be excluded. That means it will not be taken into account at all. We are going to prepare income and expenditure account only from receipts and payments account. So from receipts and payments account, the opening and closing balance of cash and bank will go, and we are going to exclude. That means we are not going to record it. Number 2, capital receipt and capital expenditure must be excluded, because income and expenditure records only revenue items. So capital receipts and capital expenditure will not be recorded. And number 3, coming to the revenue receipts, pertaining to current year alone will be recorded. It will be recorded on the credit side of income and expenditure account. When we are recording the receipt pertaining to the current year, some adjustments will be taken into account. Income received in advance. Income received in advance means what? For the subsequent year, we are receiving in the current year. That must be subtracted. Income accrued for current year. Income earned but not yet received for the current year. That must be added. Then amount relating to previous year or years. Revenue expenditure relating to current year alone recorded, and it is recorded in the debit side of the income and expenditure account. Some adjustments will also be made which are not made in receipts and payments account, like outstanding expenses of previous year and current year, prepaid expenses of previous year and current year. The next one is income or expenses relating to a specific fund will not be taken into account. Non-cash items like bad debts, depreciation, loss or gain on sale of asset, etc. will not be recorded in receipts and payments account, but it will be recorded in income and expenditure account. At last, the balancing figure may represent either surplus or deficit, which will be transferred to capital fund in the balance sheet. If the credit side total is greater than the debit side total, that means it is surplus. Surplus means profit, income over expenditure. Our incomes are more than our expenditure. Suppose if the debit side is greater than credit side, that means what? Our expenditures are more than our incomes. It represents deficit. That means expenditure is more than the income. Expenditure over income. Let us see the difference between receipts and payments account and income and expenditure account. Point number 1, purpose. What is the purpose of preparing receipts and payments account? It is prepared to know the actual cash receipts and cash payments. An income and expenditure account is prepared to know the surplus, that is income over expenditure, or deficit, expenditure over income. Number 2, nature of account. It is a real account. That means it is a summary of all the cash account. Receipts are recorded on the debit side and payments are recorded on the credit side. It is an income and expenditure account. It is a nominal account. It is similar or it resembles profit and loss account. Incomes are recorded on the credit side and expenses are recorded on the debit side. Number 3, basis of accounting. Receipts and payments account follows cash system of accounting. That is, it records only the cash items. Non-cash items are not recorded. Income and expenditure account follows accrual system. That is, non-cash items are also recorded. Opening and closing balance. Receipts and payments account starts with opening balance of cash and bank and ends with closing balance of cash and bank. But income and expenditure account is not having any opening balance, but it ends with either surplus or deficit. Nature of items. Both capital as well as revenue items are recorded. But in income and expenditure account, only revenue items are recorded. Period. In case of receipts and payments account, all cash receipts and cash payments relating to previous year, current year or subsequent year are recorded. But only items relating to the current year are recorded in income and expenditure account. Items peculiar to non-profit organization. Number 1 is subscription. Already solirka subscription na chanda. Members alla, non-profit organization la serra members alla, they have to pay subscription. It is collected from the members. எப்ப கலெக்ட் பண்ணுவாங்க, வென் இட் இல் பி கலெக்டட், பீரியாடிக்கலி, எய்தர் மந்த்லி, குவார்டர்லி, ஹாஃப்லி ஆர் ஆனுவலி. அண்ட் ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், சப்ஸ்கிரிப்ஷன்ஸ் ஆர் கலெக்டட் ஃப்ரம் த மெம்பர்ஸ் ஹூ ஆர் பிளேயிங் பில்லியர்ட்ஸ் ஆர் ஹூ ஆர் பிளேயிங் டென்னிஸ் எக்ஸெட்ரா. இட் இஸ் அ ரெவன்யூ ரெசிப்ட். ஒய் இட் இஸ் அ ரெவன்யூ ரெசிப்ட்? பிகாஸ் இட் அக்கர்ஸ் ஆஃபன். மந்த்லி தே ஆர் பேயிங் ஆர் குவார்டர்லி தே ஆர் பேயிங். நம்பர் 2 இஸ் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் ஆன் இன்வெஸ்ட்மெண்ட். Investment will be made either in financial institutions or in banks. So for that, the organization will receive interest. It is a, again, interest will be received either monthly or quarterly or half-yearly or annually. It is a revenue receipt. Sale of old sports material. What are sports materials? Nothing but balls, bats, etc. So the sale proceeds from the sale of old sports materials is considered as a revenue receipt. Sale of old newspapers, the proceeds, the amount you are collecting from selling the old newspapers is called as sale of old newspapers and it is a revenue receipt. Legacy, what is legacy? It is a gift made to a non-profit organization by a will. By a will, will na will. It is a capital receipt. Life membership fees. Amount received from members towards life membership. That is, if I want to become the member and I want to become the life member, then I have to pay life membership fees. It is not recurring in nature. I am going to pay only one time. So it will not occur often. So it is a capital receipt. Number 7, purchase of sports equipments. That is, you are purchasing table tennis tables, billiards tables, etc. You will not buy often. So they are again non-recurring in nature. It comes under capital expenditure. Number 8, admission fees or entrance fees. Fee collected from every member once at the time of admission is called as admission fees. Since it is collected only once, it may be treated as capital receipt. But usually it is recurring in income because every year new member will be admitted. So it is a revenue receipt also. So admission fee or entrance fee can be treated as either revenue receipt or capital receipt. Grants from government and other organization. What do you mean by grants? Maniyam kudukuranga government and other organization. The grants can be received for construction of buildings or for purchase of assets, etc. If it is received for this purpose, then it is treated as capital receipt. If the grants are received for payment of salary or for maintaining the assets, etc., then it is considered as revenue receipt. Donations. Anbalipu. What is donation? It is the amount received as a gift. And donations can be of two types, general donation and specific donations. Donations received without any specific purpose is called as revenue receipt. Sorry, is called as general donation and it is considered as revenue receipts. Donations received for a particular purpose with specific condition is called as a specific donation and it is a capital receipt. For example, prize fund, sports fund, etc. are examples for specific donation. Next, honorarium. It is nothing but the remuneration paid to a person who is not a regular employee of an organization. And it is a remuneration, it should be paid monthly. So it is recurring in nature, it's a revenue expenditure. Purchase of sports material. Sports material means bats, balls, etc. When you purchase these bats and balls, often we will, it's a recurring one and it is a revenue expenditure. Purchase of books for library, it is a capital expenditure.